Hello once again. Today we have another game of Age of Empires 4. We watch again Captain of Tail, or Captain Fail. With French versus Ottomans. This matchup, I don't like it because you're normally getting harassed on your gold at the beginning. Eight villagers on food. Now go on stone a gold for the fastest nut production. Versus Ottomans and Mongols, you can actually think about sending from the beginning on villagers to gold. So gather the gold faster, because normally they will disrupt your gold production with... Also, Ottomans always will do with the military school, and Mongols normally will tower rush your gold as French. So versus these two, I would probably start with a little bit different build, where I put a little bit more units on gold. But overall, that's perfectly fine. Especially on this map, the rush distance is so long, he shouldn't really interrupt any of the gold, even with this build. Should have a villager lead by now, yeah. Half a villager, because French. And School of Cavalry. Personally would have liked both one tile more forward, so this one tile more forward, this one more tile left, so you could later put farms here around your TC. But that's high critique, and normally if you're forced on farms as French, you're all... In most games you're not really in a good spot. Most of the time, so... I can understand it. Mill for wheelbarrow, also fine. Enough villagers on food. Okay, he doesn't even go aggressive with the spearman. Interesting decision. To be fair, versus French, you either send it, the first one you send instantly to gold, normally to harass the gold, and the other spearman I would keep back to keep your base safe. I have no idea what he's doing at the moment with the spearman. I think you could have put one more village on foot. Or keep this away from the berries and back on the sheep. And you could have afforded your knights 3 seconds earlier, but to be honest, it doesn't really matter. That's a case where you actually want to kill the spearmen, because they are dark edge spearmen, and he doesn't got the upgrade, so yeah, you get damage on your knight, but that's to spearman, that's good trade for you. And more barracks. So your scout should be either with the knight, and if you see more barracks, you should instantly go for an archery range. Yeah. Versus Mongols and Ottomans, because they go a lot of spearmen. You can think about sending the three villagers on gold a little bit earlier, get a Dark Age wheelbarrow, because your knights normally don't do a lot of damage versus them, because you never reach the other side. Also normally they have spearsmen on the gold, or they, also Mongols are even worse, because they can have the TC directly on the gold and stuff like that, and they don't need that much gold. Oh, nice. I think he could have killed him and would have survived. It's 2 HP. Would have been interesting, let's say me that. I think overall correct decision. That's a really bad trade. You can't out damage them, they are broken as fuck. And your archer should go forward now, and you're too much on wood. You can now. Oh yeah, that's a really nice TC spot. Berries and two deer spots and wood. So that's, I think, the first slight mistake you did. I think first of all you have too much guys on wood. In theory I like the archery range, so I would go for the archery range as well, but if you go for the archery range you don't go for the second TC. Or at least not fast, you go it really slowly. If you go the archery range, you want to non-stop produce archers. You probably want to produce more archers, so you go probably on the School of Cavalry, and you could have added in this time two more archery ranges. This guy could be on foot, and you would have a huge archer army. With knights as a front line, that's relatively strong. Nice micro here. The other way is you go fast the second TC, then you skip the archery range, because the archery range was now 250 wood wasted. You could have put a few more guys on stone, and you could have had the second TC 2 minutes earlier. That's 3.5 villagers around that time. 6, 9, yeah, close to 3.5 villagers. More. Yeah, happens. Not good, but happens. And you, the big difference would be you would have had your second TC already up. I would say 2 minutes ago running, or 1 minute ago running at least. So that's 3 villagers more. You could have then produced 2 archery ranges and then non-stop produced archers, or 3 archery ranges, non-stop produced archers with knights, no non-stop production. And you would be in a really good position now. Now you don't really have the military production. He has only 1 school, military school, 1 barracks and 1 stable. I don't know really now why he doesn't go archers, but never mind. This way. Secondly, it doesn't really work at the moment. So yeah, that should be an hot do for sure, but that's a mistake, happens sometimes. And if you have the stone, you could build a tower here at the gold, because you actually want the gold. Now the second CC is working too, that's good. So he noticed it. Not really sure why he pulls back his army. You should have had, you also should have had an extra scout out, or you should have a scout that keeps track of his army, best case. School of Cavalry is relatively good for that, because yeah, it produces scouts faster by 5 seconds than a TC, or 4 seconds faster than a French TC. So if you don't have the gold at the moment or something like that, just get a scout most of the time. The villagers should be in the TC. Yeah. The focus fire is a little bit off, but happens. So you have now 10 villager lead. And you have the better trades. In theory, this would be good. The problem is you have 8 villagers idle at the moment, so they don't work at really, so it's only a 2 villager lead. And Ottomans have more. They have the same amount of eco upgrades. But yeah, the food eco upgrade would be really good for you too. And guys on gold would be really important. Still, I'm missing a second, third, and fourth archer range. Not stable. Second archer. No, we have 3 archer ranges. I'm not the biggest fan of the second stable in this case. I rather had seen more archer ranges. A fourth maybe. Also try to get them together for the keep. For the cheaper keeps, where are they going? To this gold, why? Just get 2 extra tower here and set them to this gold, way better. Spearman would also be an option in this case, but archers, mass archers are normally so much better with knights. Why I'm not the biggest fan of the stable here is because you can't really afford the stable production. And these archery ranges should pump non-stop units. The knight should be go out and fight the Sephahis. Sephahis suck with his knights, you can fight that easily. One knight versus 4 Sihari, I think the knight loses, but 2 knights versus 4 Sihari, the knight wins, the 2 knights wins without even taking a casualty, I think, if they're full life. Because they have 3 armor and they have 0 and they deal 10, I think they deal 15 or 16 with the sword. 20 with the sword. So that's 13 damage difference, and they have more HP, 65 more HP, so that's trades you can more or less always take. Of course your knight was low, so you should have won with it, but the other 4 knights could have gone in. This should be should be a rally point here. Walls off, that's nice. I would put this knight probably back here and take these 2 knights forward. That's because there's a few options in this game state. You either start to get towers on the map, or you just you need to produce more scouts to see what he's doing. Then raids like that doesn't happen that often. Only 10 tutorial. So the big problem I see at the moment is your archer count is too low, you have not too much guys on. Yeah, it's okay with the gold. But overall the archer count is too low. The archers shouldn't be in the same control group with the knights, I would say. With the knights be on the map, attack these palisade gates, attack these palisade gates. You more or less want to be non-stop with the knights on the map and attack random stuff. Stuff like that you should see. Your archers, either you put them forward and get a tower somewhere like here and you just harass from here on out with the knights, or you can keep your archers in the base. That shouldn't happen. Also, you could actually think about skipping some knight production at the moment and go castle age. Because you don't really do anything with your knights on the map. Also the thing is, you're French, you should be stronger in the age. Also you have a lot better traits and a lot more resources. So yeah, I think it's good that you wall off here. That's okay, so he can't raid you that much anymore. That's a good thing. But you don't take map control at the moment, and that's one of the most important things with French you have to do. He walled himself here off, here off, here off, and here off. So, what is his limiting resources? Okay, he has a little bit of berries, he has Ottoman, so he gets here infinite food. He has here a little bit berries, he can spawn a lot of sheep if he wants. So he has here berries, and he has one deer patch. That's not the best, but it's okay, it's survivable for a time. His woodline, it's probably fine, so he won't run out of wood that fast. Stone, he has also more than enough. Gold, interesting, he has only one gold spot in the space. He has a gold spot, you know that. He has a gold spot and a stone spot. So, first of all, probably get towers here, 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 and here. Here is also a gold spot. So you know, the gold spots are here on the top side of the map, here, and that's your gold spots. So you can probably get a tower just here somewhere around here, so you are sure he doesn't go to this gold. You can start to send more or less all your army. Your archers probably here. Your knights can start to rest here, start to rest here. He has to run here to defend all the time. If you have also a tower here and here, or vision around here, he can't really move out to your base to attack you. What's really good for you. And you can go castle age more or less if you think you can go castle age. You don't have to produce non-stop armies. Your castle age is a lot stronger than most other. Also, French castle age is the best castle age in the game. The feudal age is really good, not the best, but it's really good. The problem is you take so the longer that game takes in the early stages, the better it is for French. So you normally want to keep it relatively long in feudal age. But if the opponent wars up like that and you're on TTC, you can probably stop a few knights Especially if you see the enemies heavy on Sifahi, or stop the archer production for a time, and your knight production because you have 14 knights. He has nothing that can kill 14 knights with his Sifahi. 14 knights kill 30, 40 Sifahis or something like that. So you are more or less have the stronger army at the moment. So you go Castle Age. Pop up keep here, get this gold, get the stone here, and you keep pushing. You take the sacred sites, you take the relics. You have the map control, you have your knights, but in your case, you. In the beginning of this game, I understand you play defensive because it's Ottomans, and Ottomans normally go from all in. Because it's the only thing Ottomans. So, Ottomans have two things they can really do. That's a feudal age archer all in, and then they go, or they go a little bit of military, go castle age, and because they get free siege units, they get a big siege push. You have way too much wood and not enough production buildings, I would say. Yeah. There's only two stables and four archery ranges, if I stated correct, three archery ranges. So with 2 TC I would go, the minimum, the starting amount is 4 archery ranges, 2 stables, I would play around. As if I go fast 2 TCs, I get 4 archery ranges around 8 to 9 minutes and they produce non-stop. 4 archery ranges, 2 stables and I have production out of all 4 non-stop. Also, you need gates in the walls. Always produce gates. Here a gate, here a gate, here a gate. Probably here also a gate because you want to move out. You have want the opportunity to move out actually. The other thing is why you are. Not on the map at the moment. You just got the confirmation he's Castle Age. You should know you have a huge villager lead. You have a huge army. And he just spent 1800 resources on Castle Age. Probably he wants to get his upgrades. And take relics. Okay, so you have a few goals. First of all, deny him the relics. Here's a relic, and I think you already grabbed some. So you want to be on the map for probably the next... So after Castle Age, you can probably keep up 1 or 2 minutes. If you see he has a unit upgraded and he has a lot of lances like he has now. He has a few lances, but it's not so strong. He has a lot of lances. Then you turn back and play like you do more defensively and get. So the Royal Institute is correct, but you should be on the map. Oh wow. You don't want something like that to happen. You want to fight him as early as the moment he hits Castle Age. You want to less. If you can force a fight the moment he hits Castle Age or in the next minute, you win the fight because he spent and you spend a lot of military. You normally win the fight because he lost all his. Your archers. So that's. So if you had the same fight 2 minutes ago or 1 minute ago, he wouldn't have the spearman upgrade, his spearman would be a lot weaker. And your knights and archers would be exactly the same strength. You would have won this fight really decisively and he could have done more or less nothing. You still win the fight because you decided to dive the TC and he's a little bit stupid, but... At the moment you don't really want to fight, and I think you have too much product. Where's all your gold? So much more guys on gold. This guy could be here. That's the other thing. Now you play defensive. First of all, you never want to play defensive in Age of Empires 4 because you have the Sada. To be fair, you have a lot better economy, but he's Ottoman, so he gets free units, so the economy isn't that that serious. That's another mistake, I would say. Don't upgrade your archers to veteran. It's just not, it isn't worth. Just get, also, yeah, if you have a lot of archers, it's okay, but now you have 12 archers. I wouldn't say it's really worth. You want to go Ablet here. Yeah, Ablet here deal less damage versus Spearman, but that's the only thing they deal less bad damage against. And to be honest, if you have 17 archers who one hit as a Spearman or 17 Ablet here who one hits a Spearman, that doesn't matter that much. Also, you probably want to focus fire with them, and you can split fire with them so good. So Ablet here in Castle Age are better in every way, and that's the reason you probably want to skip the archer upgrade. And the plus 5 damage versus spearmen, or plus 2 damage or 3 damage versus knights, and everything else is so insignificant, it's a little bit sad. I don't really understand this keep positioning. Still no gates here, so you can't really move out. Don't know why he didn't take the second sacred site. Also, why this relic is still up. But yeah, you managed with the villager lead because you, the problem is you stayed in your base. That's the biggest problem in this game. You stayed in your base and played defensively. Why? So with French, you have to be always proactive, I would say. Relatively proactive. If you see your opponent like this, walls up and stuff like that, you don't have to wall up. You play as offensive as you can. You get the spore. As I said, I probably would have put a few villagers, got one to towers here, put all my archers here. Also, if I could actually play the game. Also, this, no, it's not open. But yeah, the theory is get a tower here, get a tower here, get a tower here, get 2-3 towers here, put all your archers around here, harass with the knights here and here and here, and you win the game. You slowly go to Castle Age, boom up more behind it, go Castle Age, drop a keep here, get your cheaper units. Of course, you can slowly wall up like you did, but slowly, not fast. And now, yeah. That's the other thing with the walls, why I don't really like them. Also, just wall up here, the top. You know, cut off the base. Now you have no gold left, you have no really standing army. He has the same amount of knights more or less now than you have. He has spearmen and he has mangonels, and you doesn't have anything to counter the mangonels. You have a few spearmen, archers and Ablet here, and I think this game is over. Also, yeah, you are 40 villagers ahead at the moment, but that's 3 relics, so that's 240 gold. That's around what? 7 villagers? So that's only 33 villagers lead, and yeah, he has military schools. That's his economy bonus, if you wanna call it that. Where he gets 3 units, and now he gets Janissary. And Janissary are really good versus French, so. Janissaries and Wagonals. I probably would go Springels as well. But yeah, the third Meganel for free. You get a second keep that will do nothing. A keep here would do something because you can actually get the gold, but. So, how to use French keeps? First of all, I would try to keep my French production in a line with the archery ranges and the crossbows, or a circle, so you can later drop the keep in it, so you can build four buildings beneath each other, and on the side corner you can put four and then four again. And there you can build a keep. Normally you want it a little bit forward, so the School of Cavalier a little bit here, and you could have done it around here, so to the left probably. Would have protected this side of the map and give you the reduction. After that, so the second keep, or the, that's a keep you want defensively, that's absolutely good, and for your unit production, cheaper. The other keeps, here is a good keep location, here is a good keep location, here is a keep location, here is a keep location, here is a keep location. Here's a keep location, maybe a little bit more forwards, but you actually would have had this keep actually here. So this one is not the best. So these two are defensively, you don't really like them. Delhi it's fine, but French not really. You want them always on gold or stone, I would say. And normally on their gold and stone. And then you just build stables and archery ranges around that. In the influence area, but yeah, you have a good economy lead, but you don't have the gold income. You ran out of gold. You still didn't go to this gold. You took not a single relic. You didn't take the sacred sites. So if you produce, so if you keep your military production more or less up with French, you have most of the time the biggest military besides English Ottomans. And also yes, also if some in China Abbasid and see if they boom hard enough, but and you wait too long, but yeah. So more or less he has units, but you need to be more or less. He has the sacred sites, he controls most of the gold, he purchases you away from your gold. And that's the thing you want to do all the time. And the only thing he can afford it because he's here on the top of the gold. And that's why this wall here sucks. And that's also why this wall here sucks. We think you still have a gold here, but you don't go to it. And I think he, also he asked in the chat for a few games how you beat Castle Edge. You deny them this gold, the stone, and this gold. You had a bigger army, which could have just done it here and built towers here, keeps here. What you wanna do? He wants to push your. Also, yeah, he gets 3 units, but you think he wants to push you away with Janissary, with
Horseman Archers? That's the only units he can produce? If he hasn't gold. No gold. He can't beat Archers, Arbaletier and French Knights with only wood units. The only stuff that can play with only food and wood is Abyssid, I would say. And maybe China, because China actually can generate the gold if they produce. Also, their Suga No more or less doesn't cost gold if you have Imperial Official with them, because the tax they generate is more or less the same amount your the cost in gold. It's absolutely ridiculous. Yeah, this game. Also, this game is over. Still don't know where you actually get the gold income. Oh yeah, you have still a gold spot here, but this one's out now. Here you have two keeps. They don't really reduce your units besides these three stables. And these three stables doesn't work, while this one does. Not the best decision, but okay. They don't reduce your archers, they don't reduce your arbaletier, they don't reduce your knights or horsemen. They don't give you any map control either, and they don't secure you any gold. And you still go by archers? But archers sadly don't do any aren't that, also they are okay, especially in this age. Okay, six ablets at least, but yeah, that's against two or three Meganites. Two Chinese service, and he just wants is going to push down here now where you have no keep. Also these upgrades would be good, but you don't have the gold. This upgrade also would be good, but you don't have the gold. And I would say this is the first time you're active in the map in the past 17 minutes with knights. The big problem is it's 17 minutes too late. Also, you could have actually stopped producing knights, get the horseman upgrade, and pump horseman like a madman. You have so much food and wood, or archers, or anything. But you don't have the also unit production way too low. You could get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 6 archer ranges around here. Then you would be at 9 archers. It's still not the highest amount, and just a mass archers like a madman and gets upgrades for them. If you get enough archers, they can kill Meganess. It's not that big of a problem. We just get land formation. I really don't like the stones. I think they're absolute walls. I think they do nothing at the moment. But you have to spend these resources somewhere. Probably in production buildings and preferably into units. Either in 200 horsemen or in 100 horsemen or 100 archers or something like that. Also line formation. Way better than staggered formation. Now you haven't enough, but if you have 30, 40 archers, I think you can 2 or 3 shot Meganites, so that's actually okay. And you want way more ranged units, and also versus Ottomans, because they will go Chinese service siege units, you normally want to go Arbaletier Springles. And horsemen and stuff like that, maybe, but yeah. He has now the same eco as you, he has the better economy upgrades. Yes, economy upgrades, you don't really have them besides the tier 1s here. Here's the better military upgrades. He has all his free units and he has access to the map. And I'm pretty sure he doesn't even have that. He has one sacred site that's 100 gold per minute, I think. At least 3 relics, yeah, 3 relics still. Yeah. So you didn't produce units, that's the biggest problem. No units. Market would also have been great to trade unit resources for gold. Yeah, Janissary Siege versus Mongols, they are sick. Because actually I can also repair siege units. You want mass ablets here probably and springles. 6 stables. 7 stables and 4 archer. 8 stables and 4 archer ranges. Still not, also, as I said, not enough archer ranges by far. Probably 8-10 archer ranges would have been okay. And he could have maybe halted this fight, but the problem is with Royal Institute instead of Guild Hall, you get so much weaker over the later the game goes, the worse French usually tends to get because of that. So the strongest point is Feudal Age, is they are good in Feudal Age, they are really strong in Castle Age. And with Guild Hall and everything and trade setup, they're good in Imperial Age, but normally because they are so much better than Castle Age, you get a Royal Institute like you do, and you just keep Castle Age. So, overall, what's the problem? You did nothing in the mid game, more or less. Also, your early game was a little bit undecisive. Either go fast TC or archery range, but either go a really fast second TC, but then you don't go the archer range before, or you get the archer range but you don't really want to stop the archer production. You probably go for an all in the Feudal Age or when he hits Castle Age, but then you want to take map control. So let's see. Big villager lead, big villager lead. You lost a bunch of villager when he aged up. Interesting. Maybe I. Ah, so yeah, that was his. No, that wasn't the raid. Oh yeah, this was the Safari raid. So that kept him in the game, the raids here, because you didn't have map control. That's usual. I have that with 2 stables, non-stop production with 2 TCs around this time, and 3 archer ranges, I think. That's also a little late because you didn't produce non-stop military. Yeah. So you actually had more military until he hit, until here. So that's the interesting part. You had more military because your units cost more versus Ottomans. They have insane military because they get units for free normally. Or they always get them for free, so yeah. He hits Castle Age, so he couldn't produce more units. So you skyrocket above him. You see him, he hits Castle Age. Your decision is to turn back to your base and wall off. Why? You have the bigger army, he has no... Also, it's clear you have the bigger army because you just get to Castle Age. You know you have probably a better economy. Take map control. Here, you could, after this fight here, you won the fight. Take map control, take map control. You didn't take map control. He had castle edge, he had the castle edge lead. Had map control, got his upgrades, and then you fought. If you had map control, you could have fought here. He couldn't move out. Could have fought here. You would have won hard the fight because he didn't have his upgrade. He always got his spearman upgrades here. And then here you more or less traded equally, and that's not a good trade for you because we're French. This time you would have won the trade relatively hard. And if he doesn't fight you in this time because you're at your space and he gets the upgrade, you turn back, have this time again to around a minute until his army reaches your base. And what's a minute after here? Oh yeah, you're a castle age and your upgrades are probably more or less done to finish. So you are again on equal grounds military wise, but you have the better economy. Also, he couldn't take relics and the gold for free and kept him in the game. If you really fought on the top side for the gold, he would be out of the game because he never could have fight your army. Yeah, after that, he had map control and he just kept you on the gold because that's the thing kill people's castle age. You just pile them on, you just keep them away from gold or food. With the HRE burger push, because they don't really cost any gold and they normally get relics, and the relics alone can put finance, also man at arm costs 100 food, 20 gold. So they're cheap as shit for gold, but they cost a lot of food. So HRE actually for burger push needs deer and boar and stuff like that around the map, or they can't afford normally the burger push, or they can't afford it for much longer. So French is amazing for that because you just keep them away from the food, and the man at arms never arrive in your base because he has never the resources to produce them. And that's the same with more or less every other civ in Castle Age, just with gold. If you can keep them from the second, or the best case is second gold, if you can keep them from the third gold, that's also fine, or fourth gold. Also, you normally, because you have map control, because you are French, you have the knights, you have the strongest knights in every age, so you normally have map control in every age besides versus Dalian. That will be worse next patch, but that's a different story. So you always should have map control, so you want to take on the other side of the map the deer, the gold, everything. So more or less French plays backwards until feudal age, mid feudal age they play extremely forward, so probably half your eco is somewhere around the map trying to collect enemy gold, food and stuff you can, and then when castle age hits you probably go more backwards with your economy until you can afford more or less a few keeps, you have your royal bloodline and stuff like that finished. And if you got your upgrades and your army finished, you get more or less back on the map again and take everything. And if the enemy can push you away, of course you stay and keep everything. And that's how you more or less play French most of the time. Or you wait him to death, but that usually doesn't work that often. Military. In the end, he killed more units than you did. The early game you had really good trades, but sadly the mass Ottomans gets better, French gets worse. Here it comes the interesting thing. He had more food than you had, with less villagers. Okay, because he had map control and actually gathered okay food and had the better upgrades. Yeah, he had 4k wood less than you. I'm pretty sure you had 10k wood in the end of the game, so you didn't really spend it, so I had 1k at least, so I think you had 2 to 3k, so more or less the same because you didn't spend it. Stone actually had also more, and you don't need that much stone, so, and that's important thing, you had 9,000 gold, he had 20,000 gold. And there could be exactly the different story. He could have been on 4,000 gold and you could have been on 20,000, 30,000 gold if you just kept map control in Feudal Age. And that's the thing, you have to keep map control, that's why you have to keep your knights alive. Because if you don't have your knights alive, you normally don't have map control with French. And if you don't have map control with French, you lost the game. You need the resources, you need to keep the enemy away from gold and food, because if the enemy gets to an equal point than you get, you normally lose as French, let's say it this way. So I hope this was helpful. And good luck in your games and see you, bye!